In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to extend the range on your keyless entry system of your vehicle. It's going to involve attaching a larger antenna to the existing receiver inside of the vehicle. Now, I'm doing this with a Honda Odyssey, which is straight ahead. Even if you don't have an Odyssey, though, these same principles can be applied. You just have to know where your receiver is. So right now, I'm testing the range, just backing up until it stops working. It's still working there. Back up a little more, and there it cuts out. So we'll use this sign on the left as a reference point, and after we're all done, we will see how much further back we can get from that sign. Now in this vehicle, the receiver is in the driver's side door, and that's one reason I am testing from the passenger side, because that's going to be the shortest range. You'll get much longer range if I do this test from the driver's side. So this is basically the worst case scenario. So in my van, this is a 2009 Honda Odyssey. The antenna is actually part of the main window switches and door locks. So I'll show you how to get into here. You don't actually have to take off the door panel. This whole thing will pry up. Now you need a tool kind of like this, anything with a sharp hook on it to be able to get in here, because back here there's a clip that has to come out first. So we'll wedge this in here. And there we go. And then we go around the edges and pry the rest of it up. Clips on the inside too that you gotta get out. There we go. And then there's two connectors, one for the window switches and the other one for the mirror motors. There's one. There's the other. So the antenna is somewhere in here, so I'm gonna have to open it up and figure out exactly where the antenna is. I'll do that inside. So here's the piece taken out. Now this piece here, you may not be able to see, you probably can't, but the markings on this bit here has an FCC ID, so I'm pretty sure this is what does the receivers inside here, and it makes sense because it's part of the locking mechanism. So I want to get in there. So first I'm going to take these screws out just to make it easier. I take this whole thing out. So what do we got here? So there's the lock. There's a tiny little screw inside there. So I'm going to take that screw out and see what happens. Okay, let's see if I can pull this out somehow. Okay, there we go, and look at this coil. This coil here, that's definitely the antenna. So if we want to make a bigger antenna, we can just hook up a longer wire. So you can actually take this whole piece out so that you can work with it, just kind of wiggle this back and forth. Pull it right out. You see it actually, there's actually a plug in behind that plugs into there, and then you can just work with this. Now you can actually take the circuit board out. There's a little tab right here that's holding on to the plug portion, so you got to lift that little tab up as you pull the board out. Helps if you have some pliers. Make sure you don't crush anything on the board.
And there you go. And that'll make it a lot easier to solder something to it.
So I'm going to be using a piece of just electrical wire, 14 gauge, the normal stuff that goes in your wall. I got 3 feet of it, and I'll be soldering the one end to the existing antenna. I've already tinned both sides, both the antenna and the end of my wire, so I'm just going to solder them together with a generous amount of solder. So now it's all soldered, I need to bend this down delicately so I don't break the solder. There we go. Then we can put the board back in. Hear that click into place. And I drilled a hole in the cover where this is going to go, big enough to accommodate the wire. Now it's more of an oval. But looks like that did the trick. Now we can put this back together. Looks good. And then we can take it outside and give it a try. Okay, so I put everything back together. I ended up putting the wire, routing the wire through the arm, so it goes all the way through the arm, and I had to curl it around and back a little bit so it would fit. That was it turned out to be easier than trying to shove it down through the wall, because there's not a lot of room behind the panel because of this pocket here. That's what I did, and we'll see how much range it gave us. So I'm starting a little bit further back than we did at the beginning. You'll see the sign that we used as a marker at the beginning of the video. I'm going to keep backing up until I don't see the van lights blinking anymore, and that's about where it stops. And then about a step forward and it starts working again. So that gave us about, I'd say, 30 feet or so of extra range, which is decent. Not as much as I thought we'd get, but it's something. And again, this is the other side of the van from where the antenna is. If you go over to the other side, you'll be able to use it from much further. And I did find, too, that if I held the key fob flat, so pointing the light of the key fob at the van, I got much more range that way. And I did notice that when I used it in a crowded parking lot, I was definitely able to unlock the van further away than what I've previously experienced. So it was a neat project. I don't know if I'd suggest doing this to, you know, somebody else, unless you're having problems, like severe problems with your range on your van, but it was a neat project. So I appreciate you watching. Feel free to subscribe if you'd like to see other videos like this.